or something.
All right, I am sitting here with the dreaded Mojave Green rattlesnake. Ooh. People talk about this snake like it's some kind of monster, like it's a, it's kind of the boogeyman of the desert here. It's supposed to be super aggressive, chase you down, strike through glass, pop your uncle's truck tires, all that stuff. But really, they're not that much different than other snakes. They might be a little bit more excited when they rattle at you. That's because often they live in grasslands and places where there used to be a lot of hoofed mammals. So, you know, if you're only an inch tall, it's not very fun to be stepped on. And they react that way, but Mojaves really aren't that big of a deal, or certainly not as much as a big deal as people think. This one is acting pretty typical. It's sitting here. It would rattle if it was really all that worried, but it's just kind of hanging out. So I put it here so I could take a picture of it. And it came in that bucket from home. You just saw the video where I caught it. And I found this nice little patch of vegetation here, far from anybody. There's a couple of pack rat nests back there and lots of good places for this guy to hide. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna see if we can get this guy to show off some of that extreme behavior that Mojaves tend to do. And probably what I can even get it to do is do what a lot of people would interpret as a chase. So it wants to go back there, and if it's closer to those bushes, that's where it would go. The reason why it's out here this far and why it's not going anywhere is because it feels like this is the best place it can defend itself against me. So it's not going anywhere. But if that changed, it's going to try to get the vegetation, either that stuff or the stuff behind us. So I'm going to stand right between them, right between us, and kind of get it out of this coil. Now, it might come straight towards me, especially if I duck down. Let's see what it does. So keep in mind the whole time that this is a snake that people just really love to believe all kinds of crazy stuff about. It's not rattling. It certainly could be, but their behavior is really not a whole lot different than other rattlesnakes, especially if you've been around prairie rattlesnakes or southern Pacifics. All right, so he's gonna get a little worried about my presence. Oh, even got a little buzz. As soon as he feels he can get to cover, he's going to. He just doesn't see it, so I'm gonna move him back towards it just a little bit. And I get in the way, it backs off. If I cut it off, it stops. And watch how it always faces me. And as soon as it has a clear path again, it goes. So if I were standing in the way, I'll just let it go. Between this grass and the snake, and it tried to make a beeline for it, which can really be the case if you're on a trail or something, it can look very much like that snake is coming towards you to aggressively chase you, and that's really not what's happening at all. Very pretty snake that is a little bit more greenish than we typically see out here. And Peoria, where I'm at right now, is one of the only neighborhoods in the valley where you actually see these at houses. So I'm gonna leave them there and go find my car. See you later.